After God created the world, he made man and woman. Then, to keep the whole thing from collapsing, he invented humor!
Sub, a perfect reason to rejoice. A distinctly positioned channel in the crowded Hindi general entertainment channel space. It is India's only family comedy entertainment channel with a core brand promise of Asli Maza Sabke Saath Aata Hai.
Dekh raha hu.
Which means celebrate the joy of being together. Taking humor as a universal language, the shows on Sub are light-hearted and make up for an enjoyable family viewing experience. Indeed.
Asli Maza.
Ab to sabko pata hai yaar.
Sub TV is now on digital channel 31.8. Revan is now on KVHF channel 4.4.
Hi, I'm John Malice. Welcome to this live edition of Connect With Me on the showroom floor at Ventura TV on this Wednesday morning. Glad you are here. Today we're talking about the real estate market here in the Central Valley. Hey, is it a good time to buy or sell? We'll tell you with our expert in the house today, 436-ME-TV. And once you hit that recording, hit option 11. We're back with our guest and our sponsor today, McHenry Protective Services.
Tonight I want to discuss the importance of the television medium to the American people.
Back here on the program on Connect With Me on MeTV Fresno. You're watching us on Comcast Channel 375 as usual. If you don't have Comcast or Xfinity cable TV, then you can see us live each every Monday and Monday through Friday, live at 10 o'clock on 13.1 and 43.6 over-the-air broadcast with one of those antennas. Before we get into our program today, I do want to pass along some bad news. Our friend here on the program, he was a guest here in January of 2014. His name is Jim Lyons, 69 years old. He passed away last night here in the city of Fresno. He was in the hospital. He was in the ICU unit, and he was a longtime musician here in the city of Fresno, had played around the Central Valley since 1974, and originally from Kansas City. He served in the military. Prior to his passing, his wife had passed away as well. So now he joins his wife upstairs with a big guy. And our thoughts and our prayers to Jim Lyons, a big-time and well-respected musician. He loved life. He loved his friends. And at the end of the program today, we're going to pay a tribute to Jim Lyons, who was a guest on this program back in January of 2014. So some bad news to start this day for many people here in the Central Valley. He was known as Mr. Fresno. Hey, a quick programming note. On Friday, we're going to have Lee Brand here. He is running for mayor, and he's going to talk about that water situation out there in Northeast Fresno. It's not getting any better, my friends, because you've got lawsuits flying all over the place now, accusations going here, going there, between Henry Perea and Lee Brand, and then some of the supporters of Henry Perea and Lee Brand. They're going back and forth on Twitter. Then you got Mark Standreth over there at the city putting out these tweets. So, you know, the whole thing is a mess. And you've got the stadium situation to deal with once the new mayor gets in. You got the police chief. How long is he going to last? You've got this crime. You got Black Lives Matter. Aren't you glad you're not running for mayor? All these who would want the job? Anyway, let's get right to our program today. And I do want to talk about the real estate market here in the city of Fresno. And apparently, you know, it's been like this for quite some time. I want to roll the videotape and show you a home that's been, well, I don't know if it's still for sale, but most recently, within the last month, it was for sale right here in the city of Fresno. Nice two-story house, big upstairs. Hey, a nice staircase right there, as you can see. And I do want to tell you that our expert today was recently a guest on Channel 30. They interviewed him, and here's what he said, basically. They asked him, is it a seller's market? Is it a buyer's market? You know what? It's both. And you may be asking the question, wait a minute. It's either a seller's market or it's a buyer's market. How can it be both? Well, you know what? That's why, my friends, he's an expert and I'm not. He's going to explain how it can be both. The real estate market is still a great place to invest and really make a lot of money if you have some money to put down on a home. Looks like a nice bedroom area there, nice bathroom, because the interest rates are still fairly low. If you want a conventional loan, it's 3.75%. FHA and VA is 3.25%. And not only that, it is a great time, according to our guest, to buy a home as an investment, as a retirement property. Not only has he done the same thing for himself, but he's telling others and coaching others on how to do that, how to invest into your future. So when you retire, you have rental property and you have more than just Social Security or what other retirement accounts you may or may not have. Live in our studio right now is Don Scordino. He is with Realty Concepts. He has been selling homes and has been a realtor here in the Central Valley for many, many moons, many decades, my friends. He is an expert in the house here today, but he is here to help you give advice. He's not only here to sell himself and his company, but the fact of the matter is if you have a question, on, let's say, a rental property, maybe a problem with your own home that you're trying to sell, perhaps you want to buy a home at this stage in your life, he can give you some advice. You don't have to go see him. He's a friendly guy. He'll be honest with you. That's the main thing, is honesty and being forthright and upfront, and Don will do that. 436-ME-TV. When you get the recording, hit option 11. We'll put you directly on the program. And today's program is sponsored by McHenry Protective Services. Today we're talking real estate. Come back and join us in a moment.
It's no wonder why the city of Fresno and so many Valley businesses choose McHenry Protective and Investigative Services. With over 50 years of experience in public safety and security, McHenry's team of experts will safeguard you, your commercial property, and your next big event. Professional service, marked patrol vehicles, 24-hour dispatch, and friendly, observant, and responsive armed and unarmed guards are just a few of the reasons you should contact McHenry at 559-478-7747 or visit them online at McHenryProtection.com.
Not sure what you're watching? Want to see what's coming up next? Or just want to browse what's on without the hassle of flipping channels? Your wish has come true. Now you can view schedules for all the digital TV channels available in the Central Valley. Get local weather updates and forecasts, and listen to nationally syndicated Biz Talk Radio, all on KVHF 4.1. Rescan your TV now, then tune in to digital channel 4.1 to start enjoying the all-new TV guide.
Back here on the program on a Wednesday morning, just a reminder, toward the end of our program today, we're going to pay a tribute to Jim Lyons, 69 years old. Sadly, he passed away here in the city of Fresno last night. Not sure exactly what the complications were. I'm not a doctor. I'm not a family member. I was an acquaintance of Jim's, and our thoughts and prayers certainly go out to the family. But I got to tell you, 69 years old, Don Scordino, that's way too young, man. That's getting up into my range there, and I don't like that. 69? That is way too young. So, you know, bless his family. Rest in peace. RIP, my friend. And, you know, kind of a sad day for a lot of people here in the city of Fresno. He was known as Mr. Fresno. But 69 is just way too young, Don.
It is too young. However, we're so old that when we were young, 69 was old. But not anymore.
69 is the new 49.
Yeah, that's right.
You know, and I'm sad today, too, because he was a friend. He was a guest on this program before, and he would treat you and make you feel like you've known him for 100 years. That's how friendly he was, and a great voice, great musician.
Those are the kind of people we need.
Yeah. So, okay, Mr. Expert today.
Well, I don't know about that.
No. You've been doing this a long time. And I mean, there's, you know, if I needed real estate, I got to tell you something, and I'll give you a free plug. I don't care. If I needed to purchase a home or needed to sell a home, I'd go to one of two people. I'd either go to Don Scordino or I'd go to a guy named, and you probably know him, Harvey Bogenwright.
I do know Harvey.
Very honest guy. In fact, he helped me get my home. Very honest guy. And he's been on this program before. So I'd go to one or the other. And I say that very honestly. And if it wasn't true, doggone it, I wouldn't say it. So tell me, and I know you can talk at length about this because you have your own radio show, and I will get into that in a moment. How can it be a seller's market and a buyer's market at the same time? It doesn't make sense.
Well, it's almost like the perfect storm right now. So you have the laws of supply and demand working in favor of the seller. So there's not a lot of properties for sale, and especially not a lot of good, clean properties for sale. So when you do have a good, clean property that's priced well and it goes on the market, it can sell very quickly and probably even have multiple offers because there's more buyers than there are good, clean homes ready to go. So that makes it a seller's market. But at the same time, it's a buyer's market because the interest rates are so low. And of course, that has nothing to do with the seller. It has to do with the mortgage industry and how low the rates are.
Something just struck in my brain. So you're saying because it's a seller's market is that there's low inventory?
Yes.
That's what makes it a seller's market.
Correct. Yeah. Supply and demand. There's a high demand and a low supply of properties for sale.
Okay. And then what makes it a buyer's market is the fact that these interest rates, which I mentioned at the beginning, 3.75% for a conventional loan. FHA is 3.25%. Let's roll the videotape. It's called House for Sale. I want to show this another house that either is or was for sale just recently right here in the Central Valley. And it doesn't matter the realtor or anything else. We're just looking at a home and talking in general. What's a conventional loan? What's the difference between that and, say, an FHA and a VA?
Okay, an FHA loan or VA loan, those are insured by the federal government. And insured meaning the bank is insured in the event that you default. So it's almost like having your Uncle Sam co-sign for you.
Really?
Yeah. In fact, that's a great explanation of it. So in
so
the
if you default, then the government takes over, or?
The government will buy out the lender. So the lender can't lose, or at least they're going to lose trouble in time, but they're not going to lose money because they have this insurance through the FHA and or VA. A conventional loan is one-on-one. It's the bank making you the loan. And so if you default, the bank loses.
So when you give out advice to people that come to you that want to buy a home, which one do you recommend for them? Let's say an average family of four, a wife and her husband, they want to purchase the home. Let's say they're both working. They have two children and they're looking for, let's say, a three or a four bedroom home with two or three baths. What would you recommend for that family?
It's going to depend on their situation. And the questions I would ask is, first of all, how much of a down payment do you have? If you have 20% down, you're probably better off going with a conventional loan because
Say that again.
You're better off to go with a conventional loan, even though the conventional rates are higher.
If
you have 20% down.
So if a house is, help me with the math here, if a house is like, let's say, $500,000, make it an even $500,000, 20% of that would be what? Help me out here.
$100,000.
$100,000.
By the way, I wasn't good at math in school, but I've gotten good.
No, but you have a calculator. But not a lot of people have $100,000 to put down.
Right. And not very many people buy $500,000 homes here in the Fresno market.
No, but I'm just using that as an example.
Yeah.
That's all.
Right. And that's what makes FHA so affordable is that you can do it with 3.5% down. So let's say you were to buy a $200,000 home. That's only $7,500 as a down payment. And maybe you haven't been able to save more than $7,500, but if you did, now you're eligible to buy a $200,000 home.
So which one do you generally recommend to people that, that's best for them? It depends on how much money they have. I know that, but I know I'm generalizing here, but most people that come to you, they probably don't have a big down payment, or do they?
Yeah, you're right. Most of them don't. But I still recommend conventional if they can do that. But see, here's the advantages to FHA. FHA is actually the federal government co-signing for you, they're going to be much more lenient. For example, if you had a bankruptcy or a foreclosure or a short sale in your recent history, if you've seasoned it for 3 years after the discharge, then you can now qualify for an FHA loan. However, if it's conventional, you have to wait 7 more years. So there's a lot of people who lost their home during the recession, and they don't want to wait 7 years. So FHA is definitely the way to go.
Wow. So this is what you generally recommend to people who come to you and say, well, I want to buy the house, but we've been saving, but we don't have that much money to put down.
So really the answer is it's a counseling session first. Let's find out what your situation is so that we can find the best method for you or the best means for you. Yeah. And it's not going to be the same answer for each person.
Yeah. Now I know I got to go to break here in just a minute or so, but back in the old days when I bought my house, I used to, after work, and this was like at midnight, that's when I had time to do it. Okay. At midnight, when I was working at KMPH and I would get off at like 11, at midnight, I'd drive around various neighborhoods to look for signs and say, well, do I like that house? Do I like that house? Do I like that house? Despite what's on the internet today, and you can find any house on the internet, you can find pictures, interior, exterior, you can find if there's mold, you can find this, you can find that. Is it still kind of the good way to go if you really want to do it the old-fashioned way?
Yeah, I believe it is, but not so much to find the specific home you want, but that's a great way to find the neighborhood that you want, because that you can see in driving around. One problem with looking for signs for a specific home is you have to realize about half of those signs are already in escrow. So they're already sold.
Really?
Yeah. That's part of the seller's market.
So half of those signs that I was looking at, they were already in escrow and I didn't even know it.
Right.
So I was kind of spinning my wheels there a little bit.
Yeah, but that's actually better than looking at some sites on the internet, because a lot of those sites do not get a direct feed from our local multiple listing service. So that home may have been sold and closed escrow a year ago, and it's still out there. So be careful on what websites you use. And if you do use a website, use it in conjunction with a realtor that you can talk to personally.
Yeah. All right. Don Scordino is here from Realty Concepts. He's a longtime realtor and knows what he's talking about, my friends, and is here to give you some free advice if you want to call in. Listen, it doesn't cost you anything to, you know, watch this program and call in. Does anybody use a payphone anymore? I have not seen a payphone in years. Anyway, so it's free of charge, 436-ME-TV. And then when you hit the recording, hit option 11. McHenry Protective Services, if you want to protect your home and business, is our sponsor today.
When you're looking for KitchenAid innovation and quality, who has the answers, the selection, the price? Ventura TV Appliance. With billions in nationwide appliance buying power, more than Home Depot and Best Buy combined, we'll help you save. Our low prices on Energy Star qualified KitchenAid appliances save you energy and money, and pay no interest on select models when paid in full within 12 months. Ventura TV Appliance, serving you since 1951.
It's no wonder why the city of Fresno and so many Valley businesses choose McHenry Protective and Investigative Services. With over 50 years of experience in public safety and security, McHenry's team of experts will safeguard you, your commercial property, and your next big event. Professional service, marked patrol vehicles, 24-hour dispatch, and friendly, observant, and responsive armed and unarmed guards are just a few of the reasons you should contact McHenry at 559-478-7747 or visit them online at McHenryProtection.com.
Back here on the program, and you can, you know, despite what happened in the Giants-Dodger game on Monday night, you can look directly at me or Don at your television set. You don't have to go and take the advice of Madison Bumgarner when he said to Yasiel Puig, don't look at me. Don't. You can look at us, right, Don?
That's right.
All right.
And you can look at me. I have a real opinion on that, too.
You can, are you a Dodger fan?
Yes, I am. A die-hard, true blue, all my life, been a Dodger fan.
Okay, this show is about over now. Time is about up. Have a good day. We'll see. No. Well, in that case, don't look at me.
Yeah,
don't look at me.
Okay.
Oh, my God. Oh, Giant fan since I was 5 years old. Mm-hmm. I saw all the greats play. I even saw your buddy Sandy Koufax, Don Drysdale, Maury Wills, all the greats. I saw them all in person as a little tiny kid.
Yeah, that's how I became a Dodger fan. My dad took me to a game at the L.A. Coliseum, and Sandy Koufax out-dueled Bob Gibson.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, you didn't know I was that old, huh?
No, I thought you were my age. Anyway. All right, you can look at us, and you can call in at 436-ME-TV. Option 11, my friends, when you get that recording. McHenry Protective Services is our sponsor today. You don't want to know what I was thinking last night, okay? When Puig came up and they were pitching, I said, throw it right at his head. He's wearing a helmet. Just bean him. Bean him. I didn't really mean that.
He's been the model citizen ever since he got humbled.
Yeah, well, okay, ever since they sent him back down to the minors.
Right. I think that humbled him.
Yeah, well. Anyway, okay, let's move on. Okay, the real estate market. We have our executive producer here, and a lot of people were in the situation a few years ago when their house was upside down. And I'll get to that question in a moment because our caller is here. Good morning, caller. You're on the air with Don.
Hey, Don. How you doing?
Good, thank you.
When you're done with the show, go over to the counter and buy the book from Kelly Cadwallader. You'll love it.
You know,
Kelly.
I tried to buy one before, but they were all sold out. They went too fast.
They have them right there, Don. Go get one.
Kelly, do you have a question about real estate? Come on.
Don and I used to work together, and Don's an excellent real estate broker.
I know he is. That's why he's here.
Thank you, Kelly.
I thought you guys were just dying for a phone call, so I called you, John.
Well, not really. We're not that lonely up here. We can entertain ourselves, but you can call it. What's your question, Kelly? You must have a question or a comment. Come on. On the real estate market, you're a smart guy.
Well, I wanted to know if Don Scordino had read my book yet. That's all.
You know, I already know everything about Joaquin Murrieta, and I know that's who you wrote the book about because I paid attention in history class back in school. But
yeah,
I will have to get your book.
They do.
Yeah.
Most people think they do, Don.
All right.
All right, Kelly. Well, listen, it was a pleasure talking to you. Thank you so much for the call.
We'll see you, John.
We used
to work together.
That's great. That's great. It's good to hear you, Kelly. Thank you very much. Well, he didn't have a question, but if somebody was upside down in their house 5, 6, 7, 8 years ago, and they're still trying to come out of it, or if they're still kind of upside down, what's your suggestion for them?
If you love the home and you bought that for the right reason in the beginning, which was a place for you and your family, stick it out and make it a long-term thing. It doesn't matter what your home is worth until the time you go to sell it.
Mm-hmm.
So, and if 5 years ago you were underwater, so to speak, that was a temporary thing. Because the market values have gone up and recovered, but also hopefully your loan balance has gone down. So hopefully you do have equity. And I'll give you a personal experience. I bought a home in about 1990, bought it for $200,000. My mother said, hey, you paid too much. I go, how do you know? You're a seamstress. I'm a broker. Well, sure enough, mothers are always right. And 3 years later, the house was probably worth $160,000.
Oh.
That was back then, but I had no intentions of selling it. Before long, you know, we went through the real estate boom, and that house is probably worth $400,000. When I actually sold it, I sold it for $320,000, and so I ended up doing well because remember, I bought it for $200,000. My loan balance went down in all those years.
Did you ever live in it?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Okay. I did live in it. So my point is that the values are go up and they go down. But if in the beauty of a home is that you can use it. It's not just an investment. It's both. So maybe if you're not doing well on the investment side, values might be down at the time. Use it and enjoy it. And I mean, I have great memories of that home with the kids in the family. And it was great. So it was worth far more than the money.
Yeah. And let me ask you another question about, you know, we talked about driving around certain neighborhoods and looking at houses. This is what I did when I bought my current home. And that is when it was raining pretty hard one day, and it looked like the world was going to come to an end, and it was raining very, very hard. I went out there and looked at the house to make sure that it didn't flood around the sides or in the backyard or in the front yard or in the streets nearby. And sure enough, it was raining cats and dogs. It was raining elephants. It was raining reindeer. It was raining wolves, everything under the sun. It was raining so hard I could barely see out of my windshield. And yet, at that neighborhood where I'm in, there was no flooding, and I was thankful for that. So are these some of the tips that you would give people to go out there and look at these neighborhoods, check out who's living there, who's living next door? How are they keeping their house? You know, go ahead, talk a little bit about that.
Sure. When you drive through a neighborhood and you're considering a purchase in that neighborhood, look at the pride of that neighborhood. And if people take care of their homes, they're not parked on the lawn, you don't have spider webs underneath the cars because they haven't moved in 2 months.
There are no gang bangers next door.
Yeah. Then, you know, you probably have a good neighborhood and one that you'll love to live there for many years. And and that's why it's really important for you to keep up your own personal home, because it's not just about you. It's about your neighbors. You are a reflection on your neighbors. So people need to really take care of their places.
Let me ask you a question, because you follow politics. I know you do. I don't want to get too political here, but you grew up here, obviously. But, you know, there's always been this battle between North and South. Okay. There's the tale of two cities. There's North and then there's South. Are most of your sales north of Shaw? Who's buying homes in Southwest Fresno, Southeast Fresno, which traditionally have been known and have been characterized and labeled as bad neighborhoods, poor neighborhoods, dangerous neighborhoods, that kind of thing?
I have an answer that's going to surprise you. One of the reasons why you have so few sales in Southwest Fresno is those people don't move. They've been there for decades.
Okay.
It must be a nice place to live. And I have sold many homes in Southwest Fresno.
Talk about that on your radio show, by the way?
Sure.
You have talked about the tale of two cities, North and South?
Yes, we have. And in fact, one of the people I talked to about that was Alan Autry, our former mayor. And I think he's one who coined that term.
Yeah.
First of all, I was on Alan's show one time, and then he was on ours. There's a lot of pride in those neighborhoods.
Go ahead, caller. You're on the air. Hello? Caller? Okay, they hung up. Let's take a break. Come back with Don Scordino of Realty Concepts. 436-ME-TV. Hit option 11. You'll get in. And we're back after this from McHenry Protective Services. We'll talk more about that.
Revan is now on KVHF channel 4.4.
After God created the world, he made man and woman. Then, to keep the whole thing from collapsing, he invented humor.
Sub, a perfect reason to rejoice. A distinctly positioned channel in the crowded Hindi general entertainment channel space. It is India's only family comedy entertainment channel with a core brand promise of Asli Maza Sabke Saath Aata Hai.
Dekh raha hu.
Which means celebrate the joy of being together. Taking humor as a universal language, the shows on Sub are light-hearted and make up for an enjoyable family viewing experience. Indeed.
Asli mazaa.
Asli mazaa. Sabko saath aata hai. Ab to sabko pata
hai, yaar. Sub TV is now on digital channel 31.8.
Back here on the program, talking to Don Scordino, and believe it or not, he has a radio program on ESPN Radio here in Fresno every Saturday morning, 9 to 10, I believe, right?
An hour program. That's right.
We got some videotape and roll it from the ESPN studios here. What do you talk about on the program? Mainly real estate?
Yeah, mainly real estate, property rights, home ownership. And our guests have gone all the way from realtors and termite inspectors all the way to congressmen.
Yeah.
We've had our congressmen on the show and ask about housing legislation.
There you are. They're hosting the show. Now, let's get back to the tale of two cities. A lot of people have lived, you know, it seems to me like the people that live in southeast Fresno or even in northeast southwest Fresno, like you said, maybe they've lived there a long time, but is there a movement there? Do you see movement in those areas like you do in the north side of town?
I'm going to say you see more movement in the north. That one, I'll buy that. However,
a lot of people come to you and say, I'm not interested in buying in southeast Fresno or southwest Fresno because of the crime.
Most people realize that crime happens everywhere.
Right.
I think that's not so much a factor. Schools is a big factor.
Clovis.
Yeah.
Like Clovis.
People want to keep their kids in their current school district.
Yeah.
Move to a better school if they can. But, you know, crime is something that we are not experts on as realtors. So what we have to do is say, please go to the websites and check that out. But one thing I learned from a police officer, who this was back in the days of the neighborhood watch, just don't do your neighborhood. You got to do several others and compare. I looked at my crime watch report and I thought, oh my God, I didn't realize there was so much activity. But it turned out, comparatively, it was a good neighborhood.
Yeah. Caller, go ahead. You're on the air with Don.
Hey, Don, let me ask you a question. I have a relative or an aunt that had rentals, nice areas, and so she kept kind of asking me if I wanted to go ahead and rent one of her units. It was a house, okay? It's a three-bedroom, large bedrooms, and whatnot. Anyway, it's a great area. There's a school two blocks down, and she wanted me to rent, so I went ahead and rented it. Now, about, I would say 2 years ago, the developer and rental or salesman approached me. Says, you know, he knew that I was renting the house, and said, why don't you buy a house, because they were putting a lot of homes up, and instead of renting. And I go, well, I gave him my history and this and that. There was a downfall, like I told him, like 40 years ago, I had a bankruptcy, okay? So I'm thinking to myself, well, I'm going to be upfront with him. You know, I said, but don't worry about it. We'll take care of it, okay? So I go, how are you going to do that? And he says, we know, because we get around it, okay? He's a developer and the salesman, okay? And there are people buying left and right, okay? And beautiful homes. I'm not saying anything. So, but I didn't want to move, you know, because for the simple reason, I wasn't too sure about this developer or salesman, you know, how they can do that kind of a deal. So, but anyway, I didn't do it, and I'm very satisfied because my aunt says that.
All right.
Because we
got to wrap this.
What would you do?
We got to wrap this up. Go ahead.
Okay. I always encourage people to buy. If you're renting, you're paying 100% interest. If you're buying, you're only paying 3.5% interest. So that's my answer to that. If you can buy. Yeah, and but don't buy if you think you're going to move in a very short period of time, because you really do sink your roots for a while.
Yeah. Hey, let's get back to some video. We have some more video from you hosting that show on ESPN Radio every Saturday morning, 9 to 10. And what are the call letters there?
It's
the number?
It's 9:40 a.m.
9:40 a.m. on your radio dial. There you are there in the studios at ESPN. Has the issue, and I know you've had politicians on your show. You had Esmeralda Soria on. She's a city councilwoman talking about the real estate market. But let me ask you this, because there's so much talk about Northeast Fresno and that water situation. Have you had people say to you that come into your office that want to buy a home, I want to stay away from Northeast because of that discolored water and lead and all that? That could be a major issue, and it could be a blow to the real estate market there.
Well, and surprisingly, I've had one person so far say that they want to avoid the water problems. They didn't say they want to avoid Northeast Fresno. They said they want to avoid the water problems. So there's a simple solution for that. You have the first 17 days of an escrow to do any and all inspections you may want, a home inspection, termite inspection. Do a water test. I'm doing one right now on my own home.
But that's only come up once with any of your clients? Because that's an issue that's been all over the news, as you know. And I'm thinking to myself, you know, my God, if I owned a house out there and I wanted to sell, maybe, you know, I'd go to a guy like Don Scordino or Harvey Bogan. I'd say, God, am I going to have a hard time selling now?
You know, it has that potential if it gets... if it blows up more than it is right now. I think right now many people are taking a wait and see approach, because it really has affected just a small portion of people.
I think there's about 400 plus homes that have tested positive for lead, and a few more that get the discolored water when they open up the tap. But it's been going on out there, my God, Don, since 2003 or 2002, as I understand it. That's
right.
A long time. Why didn't the city jump on this? We can't answer that. You can't answer that. I'm just talking out loud. But I'm just wondering how that's affected the real estate market out there.
So far, it hasn't. We do have a disclosure now to let people know what they're getting into.
You have to disclose that by law?
Just that there's the potential. Not by law. It's our company policy. And most companies here are doing that, too. We just want to disclose.
Just to be honest?
Yeah, to be honest, make people aware that, hey, this is an issue that could come up.
Yeah. Hey, let's. Do we have any more videotape of Don over there at ESPN Radio? I just want to know. If we do, let's roll it, because tell us a little bit before we get back into the real estate market and some investments and what this 1031 exchange means here. I want to get into that, but talk about how you started this radio show, which you're committed to every single Saturday? You can't go to the coast if you want to? You have to do this radio show, do you?
Well, I want to do the radio show. Okay. So we plan our trips around it.
Okay.
And every once in a while, but you'll never know it, we do pre-record the show. But it's funny how it got...
Can people call in?
We don't actually look for callers, because we have guests on the show, and it's a guest-driven show. We could take call-ins, but we don't promote that.
Yeah, you don't promote it. So what kind of things do you talk about besides real estate? You've had politicians on. What else do you talk about?
Yeah, as an example, we've had both Henry Perea and Lee Brand on the show many times.
Talking about?
City and county issues, housing issues, what city policies and county policies have to do with housing issues. And both of them have been great guests. I love them both.
Yeah.
I won't say who I'm going to vote for, but that's what we've been talking about. We've had many of our city council people there. You just saw Esmeralda on there.
Right.
And it's a great format. It's a non-controversial show. You know,
Unlike this one?
Yeah, yeah. I try not to throw them curveballs. I think you threw me one in the beginning.
I did? No,
I'm just teasing. I just threw you a curveball.
Like Bumgarner and Puig?
Yeah, there you go.
I would never do that to you.
But it was actually an accident how the show got started. I wrote an article to the Fresno Bee on Pride of Home Ownership, and I wrote another article to our members in our membership newsletter.
Yeah.
My assistant accidentally attached the wrong document to the Fresno Bee, and they published it in the Bee. And what that article said, which was supposed to go to our members, it said, for far too long, our local media has had to depend on out-of-touch and out-of-town data crunchers to tell us what's happening in our own city. It's time we step up and be the voice of real estate. Let's give our clients the real facts. What's happening here in the Central Valley, not what's happening in Michigan or Florida.
Yeah.
The Bee published it. I was ready to move to Mexico. I was so embarrassed. My poor assistant, I think she was already booked a flight for Mexico, but my phone started ringing Monday, and some guy called from a radio station called and said, you just wrote a perfect job description for a new talk show.
Yeah.
Give us the local news. What's happening locally?
Okay. What's the average price of a home here in the city of Fresno, medium?
$240,000 right now.
Okay. Is that one of the lowest in the state of California?
Yeah, I think only the Inland Empire would be slightly lower, and that would be San Bernardino and Riverside.
Okay, those are the only other two that might be lower, but lower, obviously, and more affordable than, say, Sacramento. Obviously, the Bay Area is, like, out of sight, L.A. But what about further north, like Redding? How do we compare to Redding and some of the northern parts of the state?
That's a hard one to answer, because as you get up towards Redding, you start getting 2 to 5 acres attached to your typical home.
Yeah.
So that raises the prices. But yeah. I'm going to say your big difference is not north or south, but it's east or west. So the closer you are to the big pond, the Pacific Ocean, the higher the prices are. The further inland you go, the lower they go.
Yeah, and still Fresno is a very affordable city to live in. Hey, how about your investments? We'll talk about that on the other side of the break. McHenry Protective Services, your sponsor today on the program. 436-ME-TV, option 11. And back in a moment.
Sports is now on KVHF 4.3.
When you're looking for KitchenAid innovation and quality, who has the answers, the selection, the price? Ventura TV Appliance. With billions in nationwide appliance buying power, more than Home Depot and Best Buy combined, we'll help you save. Our low prices on ENERGY STAR qualified KitchenAid appliances save you energy and money, and pay no interest on select models when paid in full within 12 months. Ventura TV Appliance, serving you since 1951.
It's no wonder why the city of Fresno and so many Valley businesses choose McHenry Protective and Investigative Services. With over 50 years of experience in public safety and security, McHenry's team of experts will safeguard you, your commercial property, and your next big event. Professional service, marked patrol vehicles, 24-hour dispatch, and friendly, observant, and responsive armed and unarmed guards are just a few of the reasons you should contact McHenry at 559-478-7747 or visit them online at McHenryProtection.com. Back here on the program, and Don Scordino is here, and you have told me in the past that you are a big believer in investment property. In fact, some of the advice that you have given people is that you should buy as much property as you possibly can, turn them into rentals, and that's your investment, long-term investment, if you want to retire.
Sure. It's a great
way. Tell people how you did it, because you have a lot. I don't want to say how many rentals you have. I'll let you say it if you want to. But how does one do that, especially if, you know, the money isn't exactly rolling in?
First of all, you have to be prepared for it. And the way I got started, I was in my 20s. I saved up, made a down payment, bought the home, moved in and lived there for about a year, saved up some more money, bought another home and moved into it. And I rented out the first one.
Okay.
And then I did that again and again. And then I got to 5 and a recession hit in the early 80s. And I realized, whoa, I'm in over my head. But I stuck it out. And I looked at those properties as my investment piece. And my idea was to keep those until I retired. And they would become my retirement income in the event Social Security wasn't around or sufficient. After those 5, I took a little break from buying. I bought a few more later on, and it's public record, so I could tell you I'm now at 14, and I manage them myself. It's a lot of, it's fun if you look at it like that. It is a part-time job, because when that water heater goes and they call you and they need help, you need to kind of drop what you're doing and be able to make that call.
Okay, so you're up to how many homes now?
14.
14, and that's your retirement besides whatever else you get. And that's a great way to retire. Good advice for anyone that wants to do that. What are some, okay, you mentioned it's like it's a part-time job. Some of the headaches is, okay, you got to replace the hot water heater, you got to replace a toilet, maybe the roof, maybe some other major things. But what are some of, I want to talk about the headaches and the benefits. Talk about the headaches first, the bad news first. The headaches are what?
Okay, the headaches are usually if you picked the wrong tenant. And here, maybe you've painted the home, put in new carpet, and a year later you have to evict the people because they didn't pay. And then you finally get possession of the home when the sheriff lets you in the door.
So does that happen to you? You've had to do that?
Oh, yeah, yeah. And never have liked it. I mean, I always tell people, please leave a day or two before, you know, leave with some dignity. Don't have the sheriff have to throw you out. And most of them do that. But then when you go in and you see that the house is trashed and they've stripped things and they were slum tenants.
And that's
a hard one because you not only did you take a financial hit, but now it's going to take a month or so to get the property habitable for a new family.
That's going to cost you some money.
Yeah.
So those are the drawbacks, some of the drawbacks. And the slum tenants, you can't really predict when that's going to happen. And does that discourage a lot of people from wanting to rent property?
Oh, yeah.
It does, because they don't want to put up with the headaches, right?
Right. But proper screening can help you minimize that. And by proper screening...
How do you do that? That's the question.
I go by the place that they live now, and I'll knock on the door and... If they only open the door like 2 inches and say, what do you need? Then you know that the inside's probably not so nice. If they say, hey, come on in. Let me show you what our home's like so you know what to expect. Now you may have a good one. And then the other thing I like to do is go 2 landlords back. If you call the existing landlord and they're trying to get them to move, they're probably not going to tell you they're bumps. But if you go 2 landlords back and they say, oh, yeah, I remember those people, never again. Well, then you know that you got a bad one.
And some of the benefits are what?
Oh, the benefits are great because you have income on a monthly basis that can help you offset the your mortgage that you may have on it and your taxes and insurance. But there's also appreciation. You think back to the first one I bought, which was for $44,000, and today it's worth $200,000. So I've had this quiet appreciation over the years. Then there's the tax benefits, too.
Mm-hmm. And what's a 1031 exchange where if you purchase 3 or more, you defer the tax gain until when?
Yeah, that's one of the tax benefits.
I don't quite understand that, the 1031. Explain that.
Here's what 1031 is, a tax code that says, okay, normally you sell an investment property and you have to pay capital gains taxes, which could be as much as about a third of your profit from the home. But if you do a 1031 exchange, IRS says you're not really selling, you're actually just replacing property. So and there's certain rules that apply, but you can, and I've done several where I bought 3 new ones off one sale, and that's how I was able to expand to 14 without coming out of pocket. So I used the equity from the one I sold and bought 3 others.
Okay. I want to put up a picture of Somerset Village Apartments. And, you know, this was in the news. So I mean, there it is right there. Chris Henry was the owner of this. He's an out-of-town owner, an absentee owner. He was fined by the city. He's got lawsuits against him all over the place. This place shut down last year because there was no water, no running water, no heat. The place was a mess. The people had to move out. In fact, one person died because it happened in the middle of winter and it was cold. You've had both Lee Brand and Henry Perea on. What have they talked about in terms of slumlords? Because I know the city council recently passed an ordinance that really puts a lot of restrictions on people that don't take care of their property.
And what I would like to say to that is people that don't take care of their properties are twofold. There's the landlord and there's the tenant. And it goes both ways. And both parties have rights. So if the landlord doesn't take care of it, we don't need any new laws right now. I mean, all you have to do is contact the county health department and report it, and they'll make the owner do something. Or you call code enforcement. So people cannot be afraid to call if there's something wrong. Now, it goes the other way, too. The landlord is protected. If you have a slum tenant, so to speak, you can evict them for breach of contract. Yeah, it's going to cost some money to evict them, probably $800 to $1,000 in attorney fees and court costs, and then all the downtime of doing that. But those are the rights. So there's responsibilities on both sides.
There was an outrage when Steve Brandow, the city councilman, of course, brought up the fact that there are slum tenants. You know, when this Chris Henry thing came up, and he was public enemy number one, faces all over the Fresno Bee and all over the news, that how could he do this? You know, no running water, no heat. But the fact of the matter is Brandow brought up the fact that we have a problem with slum tenants in this city as well. And that kind of created a little bit of controversy and an uproar with some people, but it's true.
Well, I have firsthand knowledge that it's true.
Yeah, but you're one also that you're a landlord that takes care of the property. You're not a Chris Henry. You're not like him. You take care of your properties. You've not had these problems. So, is there a trade-off between the tenants and the landlords? Okay, the landlord's got to take care of the place, but so do the tenants.
I'm going to say that most landlords and most tenants do what they're supposed to do. And that's
most.
Yeah. It's the handful. It's the old expression, one bad apple rots the whole basket. And so, yeah, there's bad landlords and there's bad tenants out there. What we need to do is focus on both of those groups and get both of those groups to bring up their standards so that it makes the whole look better. And it would be beneficial to everybody. A blighted property runs down the neighborhood. And it's like I said earlier in the show, it's not just about your home if you don't maintain it. It's about your neighbors.
Yeah. And this was a major controversy for a long time in the news. The Somerset Apartment Village complex, no running water, no heat for a long time. Located right there. I believe this was in Clint Olivier's district, and PG&E came out, and this happened in the middle of winter. And so, you know, the problem is if you're a landlord that wants to take care of your property, and you have these tenants that don't, and it's costing you money month after month after month, you know, that can be a problem. Anyway, we're out of time, Don. I appreciate it very much for some of the advice. So it is a buyer's market. Because
the interest rates are so low.
That's right. And it's a seller's market because of the inventory.
Correct.
All right.
Low inventory.
Yeah, low inventory. All right. Thank you for your time. And come back. You're going to come back on the show?
Well, if you ask me back.
Yeah, I'd love to have you back.
I'm a little shy, but I'll make it.
What? Kidding me. You got your own radio show. You're great.
Thank you.
Full of knowledge. Full of knowledge. All right. As mentioned at the beginning of the program here, time to pay a tribute to Jim Lyons. He was known as Mr. Fresno, playing his piano all over the city of Fresno since 1974, a great musician. He passed away last night at the age of 69. Not sure what the complications was. I understand he did have a case of pneumonia, but I'm not sure of the cause of death. It doesn't, you know, at this point, he passed away at 69. He played in places like the Velvet Turtle, the Hilton Sky Room, most recently Slates, the High Sierra, the Palms, originally from Kansas City, Missouri. His wife passed before him. He was in the military. And he will be sorely missed by the people of Fresno who went out every Friday or Saturday night and ate dinner and listened to Jim Lyons. Here's the tribute. Have a good day. See you tomorrow.
Next song is dedicated to my beautiful wife, Elaine.
We've got to win our third ranked date. Taylor's unranked, and they're going to win them all.
She believes in you. She believes in you.
It's no wonder why the City of Fresno and so many Valley businesses choose McHenry Protective and Investigative Services. With over 50 years of experience in public safety and security, McHenry's team of experts will safeguard you, your commercial property, and your next big event. Professional service, marked patrol vehicles, 24-hour dispatch, and friendly, observant, and responsive armed and unarmed guards are just